Yo, what's up with YouTube? It's Roddy. Today I'm gonna do another how-to video. The last how-to video I did was about the computers. Well, not about computers. The last one, let me think back. It's been a minute since I did a how-to. Yeah, it was one about phone memory and how to clear phone memory and get yourself more space on the Android. And I showed how to do it with two different phones. Today, how-to is going to be a little different. It's going to be about memory of the human kind, you know, human memory. Today, I'll be showing you how to have photographic memory. Okay, so first, I'll start off with getting enough rest gives you more energy. So you want to try to sleep at least about 8 hours whenever you can and get a real good rest. And that helps out your memory as far as you have your blood flow and circulation better into the brain. And, you know, they also use that as psychological warfare right there, where they use sleep deprivation and messes with people's memory and start messing with your mind and stuff like that. So that's one of the things. One of the things is making sure you get enough of rest for your mind. That helps the blood flow, like I say. So that's really going to help out with that circulation. Next is some of the stuff that you can take, like B12. B12 is real good energy wise. I take a B12 every now, B12 vitamin. It helps out energy wise. Also, I heard of ginseng. I don't really take ginseng, but it's supposed to be real good for energy. And another thing would be ginkgo biloba for the mind, which I've taken some before, and I don't know. I know it's good for the blood flow to your mind, though, because like whenever I've taken it, only thing you have to remember with that is it can't be mixed with aspirin. So if you take anything that's going to give blood flow to the mind, though, you can't take an aspirin that day. Yeah, that's one of the main things, because I didn't know about that whenever I used to mess off getting cold. But I mean, I still got something. I don't really probably mess off with it, though. And that's the main stuff for your energy and your blood flow to the brain, which helps out with memory overall. Okay, next, let's get into how you can have photographic memory, even if you don't. All right, you take out your cell phone, take a picture. Oh, there you go. Within 1 second, that just tells you how to have a photographic memory. All your stuff you have right there in your pocket, because you always have your cell phone in your pocket. So now you got, you can take that list for the grocery store, or handwritten note, etc. Take a picture of it, boom, you got it with you. You always have it right there in your pocket. So it'd be like, oh, well, you forgot this and that off the list. No, I got it right here. Let me see, I'm looking at the list right now. I know perfectly what it was, you know? So you don't have to, you know, we got new gadgets. We got to work as hard as you used to. And yeah, that's the secret to photographic memory. Also, you have your ability to record audio and visual just by hitting camera. You also have the ability to just record the audio. Let's go and record the sound. So you can have a sound notes and put it on voice recording. Yeah, they got this gadget I seen a commercial on TV where they had this little recording device, and the lady says, oh, remember I parked the car on such and such road. I'm like, yeah, that's a pretty nice device, but yo, everybody has smartphones now. You can just do that with your phone. You wouldn't need to buy a standalone device just for that. I mean, back in the day before smartphones, yeah. But I don't know. I don't know who that's catered to. I think it's more the old school people that don't want to get to the, you know, some people still don't want to get up with smartphones. Still got a little resistance with the older cats. So I guess that'll be like a targeted group for them. But yeah, so, and that's the key to having 1 second photographic memory. Hopefully this how-to has been useful to you. If it has, then go down and hit the like button, subscribe. It's Rod D of Orange Ninja News. We broadcast daily. And as I always say about this time, y'all be blessed and peace.